At the start of this millennium, the NBA had its fair share of cocky players, gunners who wanted the ball in their hands as much as possible. Yet, if you can back your words with your play, that's anything but criticism. It's not a secret that Kobe Bryant and Allen Iverson were among the league leaders in points per game, in part because they had the belief they could score every time they were on offense. Yet, one player may have topped even their level of cockiness. Enter Gilbert Arenas. What up everybody, my name is Stefan and this is Heat Check. Let's get into it. The 2012 NBA draft wasn't the first time that the Golden State Warriors managed to find a player in the second round that would prove at least a better fit, and at most, a better player than the guy in the first round. Taking Draymond Green with the 35th selection in 2012 after Harrison Barnes had come 7th and Festus Ezeli 30th can be considered the younger cousin of what transpired in 2001. In that year's draft, the Dubs, who had finished 17 and 65, took Jason Richardson with the 7th pick. Don't get me wrong, Richardson had a more than solid stint in the Bay Area, averaging more than 18.5 points per game there in 5.5 seasons. Yet, at the start of the second round, the Warriors took Gilbert Arenas, who had averaged 15.8 points at the University of Arizona. Agent Zero had decided on that jersey number in college because, as he said, zero is the number of minutes people predicted I would play my freshman year in college. Entering the league, Arenas had a solid first season statistically, especially by second round rookie standards, with averages of almost 11 points, 3.7 assists, and 1.5 steals while hitting 34.5% of his 3-point attempts. His 32 points against the Los Angeles Clippers on March 21st, 2002 didn't make many headlines, mostly because the Dubs lost that game and because the team was once again awful, ending the season with a 21-61 record. However, it did show that Gilbert had potential. Arenas' rookie campaign showed a lot of promise, so when the new head coach Eric Musselman came in the summer of 2002, he made the guard a starter, a decision that would have major consequences. Agent Zero justified the coach's trust in the best way possible. Starting all 82 games, the guard's production increased so much that even the casual NBA fan now knew his name. Arenas averaged 18.3 points, 6.3 assists, and 4.7 boards per game, and even slightly improved his 3-point accuracy despite attempting almost 4 threes per contest. Somewhat ironically, his best game that year may have come against the Washington Wizards, which included Michael Jordan in his final year. Arenas gave Jordan's team all they could handle, scoring 41, including 4 three-pointers, in a Wizards victory, while adding 6 boards and 5 assists. And that's not by accident. Check out the interaction that MJ and Gilbert had in 99 that he still remembers to this day.
He said, "You remind me of a player on my team." And no discredit to the player, but when he told me the player's name, I was really pissed. So he was like, "Yeah, you remind me of this player, you know, that played with me." And I'm like, "Oh, Scottie Pippen? Yeah, I'm Scottie, yeah." He was like, "Randy Brown." And I said, "Who?" He's like, "Randy Brown." "What do you mean, Randy Brown? Like, what are you talking about? First of all, I'm scoring 40 a night against high level. They're, all those guys is ranked. You got Darius Miles, you Quentin. You got all these are number one guys. They're in college too. And you're calling me Randy Brown like I'm some defensive guy? What the are you talking about?"
Knowing what we know now, you can see why Arenas was particularly motivated against MJ. Speaking of cockiness, this is how I'm gonna talk about today's sponsor. So let's see if I can hold it till the end. YouGov provides an easy way for you to earn extra cash and gift cards just by sharing your opinion. Share your thoughts about topics like politics, public affairs, brands, or products. Right now, they have an ongoing poll about the upcoming election and much more, so go check it out. It's free to join, then you earn points for completing those surveys, and at the end, you can exchange those points for cash. So then you can buy LED strips like I did back there, or just have a great night out, or do whatever you like with it. So yeah, click the link in the description and start making money. Thanks YouGov for sponsoring this video. Back to the 02-03 season. Though the Warriors had a solid, by their standards at the time, 38-44 record, they once again missed the playoffs. Arenas, however, at an individual level, was starting to live the dream. He received the NBA's Most Improved Player Award and had several months prior been named Most Valuable Player of the Rookie-Sophomore Game during All-Star Weekend. Because he was a second round pick, the capped out Warriors were unable to match Washington's 6-year, $64 million offer to Arenas, who had completed his 2-year rookie contract. The so-called Gilbert Arenas rule would be introduced several years later to prevent such situations in the future. Agent Zero, for his part, had decided on heading to Washington after he'd reportedly flipped a coin to determine whether he would join the Wizards or the Clippers.
Clippers, Washington. Which one? Do I really want to go all the way East Coast? Or do I want to just stay home? Let me flip this coin. Whatever it lands on the most, I'm going to go opposite. It landed on the Clippers. So, let's go to Washington.
Though his first year in Washington wasn't that different statistically from the previous season, with averages of 19.5 points, 5 assists, 4.5 boards, with 37.5% accuracy from deep, it did include another 40-point game, this time against the Orlando Magic. Arenas, though, once again failed to be a part of the postseason. The following season, however, everything would be different. Gilbert once again upped his scoring, this time to as many as 25.5 points per contest, leading the Wizards to the playoffs, alongside Anton Jameson and Larry Hughes for the first time since 1997. Expectedly, he made his first All-Star team that year and was even named to the All-NBA third team. In the playoffs, the fifth-seeded Wizards faced the Chicago Bulls, with Game 5 being the most interesting and, in a way, his coming-out party on a national stage. With the game tied up at 110, Arenas gets the ball and moves everyone out of the way, shoots over two guys at the buzzer, and swishes the game winner. The Wizards defeated the Bulls in Game 6, but were afterwards swept by the Miami Heat, led by Shaquille O'Neal and Dwayne Wade. The following two seasons, though, is when he became a household name. Per game averages of almost 29 points, 6 assists, and 4 rebounds, with almost 36% from 3 on 7 attempts over those two campaigns, don't even begin to tell half the story. Rarely did a day go by without Arenas being in the focus of fans, media, or other players alike. Whether it was him yelling out hibachi, signifying that he was cooking defenders on a hot grill,
you know, and then I shot it and I was like, hibachi, and it went in. And the guy turned around, what? You just got hibachi, you just got burned. The arm is a hibachi, so when it gets hot, you can't stop it. So that's why I said, like, when I'm shooting, you're sticking me, you're getting cooked.
Or as block, possibly making him the only athlete to actively block, Agent Zero was in the public eye more than ever. Most interesting, though, was the so-called Vendetta Tour against Mike D'Antoni's Phoenix Suns and Nate McMillan's Portland Trail Blazers, the two coaches that were part of Team USA for the 2006 World Championships, from which Arenas was cut and didn't make the team, and ultimately won the gold medal. In typical Gilbert Arenas style, he tried to go all out against them. So against Phoenix, Agent Zero went off for 54 points, including 6 for 12 from deep, in a 144-139 win for the Wizards. Though he didn't fare well against the Blazers, as they focused strictly on him defensively, what's crazy is that the Suns game wasn't the best one that season. It was the Kobe Bryant-led Los Angeles Lakers that were on the receiving end. 5 days prior to the game against the Suns, Agent Zero had exploded even more. The 60 points, 8 assists, and as many rebounds in LA in a 147-141 overtime win for the Wizards made even non-NBA followers Google his name. Again, in his style, Arenas bowed down to the crowd and staples at the end of his flashy performance there. Yet, perhaps his most cocky move came against the Utah Jazz several weeks later. He scored 51 points, but what he did on the final possession is possibly the most memorable image of him for fans to this day. Arenas shoots a 3 at the buzzer and turns around with his hands up to celebrate as the ball was still in the air, a true trendsetter for today's NBA players, though we're yet to see this being done with the game on the line. Needless to say, hibachi was an all-star both years, 2006 when he also made the All-NBA third team again, and 2007 when not only did he make the second team, but also finished 8th in the MVP race. Despite all of that, the Wizards never made it past the first round, because both years they were eliminated by the LeBron James-led Cleveland Cavaliers. The fact that the 2006 matchup is a highly memorable duel and that Arenas averaged 34 points over the 6 games was no consolation to both Agent Zero and the Wizards fans. The 34 points and 47.3 minutes per game averages even meant Gilbert was the playoff leader in those categories. When it comes to the 2007 sweep, though, it is a result mostly of the sad fate that would plague Arenas perhaps until the end of his career. In April of 2007, right in the prime of his career, the guard injured his his knee, which forced him to miss these playoffs. Not only that, but in 07-08 and 08-09, he would appear in just 15 games. In the 2008 playoffs, with arenas limited to just 23.5 minutes a contest and 4 games, the Wizards lost yet again to LeBron's Cavs in the first round in 6 games. Despite that, the Wizards believed in Arenas, re-signing him to a 6-year, $111 million deal in the offseason. Things didn't go according to plan, to say the least. In 2009, mostly due to the aforementioned injury, the team didn't even make the playoffs. Nonetheless, 2009-2010 was supposed to be a different season. On December 18th, Gilbert reminded everyone of his abilities, scoring 45 against his former employer, the Golden State Warriors, in what would eventually turn out to be likely his last truly memorable game in a Wizards uniform. That was so because December also saw shockwaves around the league and even beyond. After an argument that started on the plane ride, Arenas and teammate Jarvaris Crittenden brought guns into the team's locker room. According to Caron Butler, who was part of the team at the time, Gilbert told Jarvaris, "Hey, come pick one," while pointing to the weapons. He added, "I'm going to shoot you with one of these." His decision to point finger guns in the air during a home introduction after the incident and with the investigation still underway by the league made matters even worse. The NBA suspended both without pay for the remainder of the season. Though Arenas would express remorse, he was given 2 years probation. Now is the right time to mention that Crittenden was not someone to mess around with. In 2015, he pleaded guilty to voluntary manslaughter in 2011, killing a 22-year-old mother of four. As part of the plea deal, Crittenden was sentenced to 23 years in prison. But back to Hibachi now. Considering everything that transpired, it was an open secret that Wizards management were actively shopping him the following season. In mid-December, they found a taker in the Magic, against whom Arenas had scored 31 in the previous month in a somewhat turn-back-the-clock performance. According to an ESPN article after the trade, the Wizards felt that Arenas had trouble committing to the franchise because he felt they didn't do enough to support him in the wake of the gun incident and his subsequent behavior. One reporter noted that Arenas scored 31 against the Magic because he was auditioning for that position. Orlando, after the 2009 finals and the conference finals the following year, went all in. But unfortunately for them, that gamble didn't pay off. It was obvious that Hibachi, who switched his number to 1 in honor of Magic great Penny Hardaway, wasn't the same. Serving as Jameer Nelson's backup, he averaged a paltry 8 points in 21.8 minutes per game, with just 2 starts. In the playoffs, where the Magic lost in the first round to the Atlanta Hawks, his minutes average even fell to 16. So, after the 2011 lockout, it wasn't that surprising that the Magic waived him via the amnesty clause. His last career stops were an uninspiring and brief stint of just 17 games with the Grizzlies in Memphis, which saw another first-round playoff loss, as well as a season in China. Though his playing days have been over for more than half a decade, Arenas has stayed relevant thanks mostly to his No Chill podcast. Also, he's still in contact with current players. A good example of that is his communication with Dwight Howard. As he posted on his Instagram after the Lakers championship this year, Howard asked him last summer what he would need to do to become a champion, to which Arenas said he needed to win the mental battle he would see when he put on the Laker uniform. Gilbert added in the post, "Congratulations champ, you passed the test." He's in touch with LeBron too, as he showed recently again on Instagram in a post in which he praised James's ability to consume information. In the end, the debate will live on. Whether the knee injury or the gun incident was the key development that derailed what should have been, in all likelihood, a Hall of Fame career. As is usually the case, the truth lies somewhere in the middle, meaning that it was probably a combination of both things. Despite that, Arenas is and will be rightfully remembered as one of the most electric scorers, a player who, together with Kobe, the Answer, and some other players from that era, made it cool to be cocky on the court. That may be the ultimate sign of confidence, especially if your words are followed by buckets, as was the case on many occasions with Agent Zero. That concludes the video for my all-time favorite player, Gilbert Arenas. That's it for now. Subscribe and talk to you in the next one. Peace out.